So today, as we have discussed the contributions of Panchanan Maheshwari, we'll be also discussing about the contributions of BGL Swami, who is also one of the notable embryologists. Okay, so he was also a botanist who has contributed a lot for the field of embryology. Not only that, even for plant anatomy, he has contributed a lot. Okay, so we'll go ahead with his biography. Okay, this is his picture. So BGL Swami, BGL means it is Bengaluru Gundappa Lakshmi Narayana Swami. Okay, as we all know, this DVG, DV Gundappa, who is one of the notable poet of Karnataka. So BGL Swami is son of DVG. Okay, so we'll go ahead. So BGL Swami is also known as Bengaluru Gundappa Lakshmi Narayana Swami. So he was born in the year 1918. Okay. And with respect to his contribution, so he was a very good botanist. Not only that, in Karnataka he is famous for his writings. So he has written lot of novels and lot of biographical stories, and even his experienced stories, all those things he has written. Okay, so that we will discuss later regarding all those things. So we'll focus majorly on with respect to botany, what are his contributions or works related to botany. Okay, so BGL Swami was a botany professor, so was also an head of botany in Presidency College of Chennai. Okay, he was also principal for some duration. So as we all know, so he is the son of DVG. So with respect to his education, so he has completed or studied in Central College, Bangalore. Okay, so now we have Bangalore City University. So that was the place where BGL Swami has been studied his degree. Okay, yes, a BSc degree. Okay, then after his BSc degree, so he has worked in Indian Institute of Science, Bangalore, as a research fellow or research person. Then after or while doing his research, in IISc, Indian Institute of Science, he came under the influence of Panchanan Maheshwari. Okay, so Panchanan Maheshwari was to some extent a guide to BGL Swami. Panchanan Maheshwari was a guide to BGL Swami. With the help of Panchanan Maheshwari, BGL Swami was able to get many of the contacts of various scientists. Not only various scientists, even he was able to get lot of contacts with other universities. Okay, many universities, not only Indian, even with the universities of foreign countries. So that has helped by Panchanan Maheshwari, because Panchanan Maheshwari was famous enough to teach, guide, as well as even to tell about the universities or the research center that is been there in various countries. Okay, so that was the guidance by Panchanan Maheshwari. Not only that, he has also influenced BGL Swami to take over this embryology studies. Okay, then after his research to some extent in Indian Institute of Science, he was able to get his Doctor of Philosophy, PhD, okay, from Mysore University. From Mysore University in 1947. So that is during our independence. Okay, so he obtained his PhD from University of Mysore in 1947. Okay, so later on he has also obtained postdoctorate award or postdoctorate from Harvard University. So there he got a guide named as Dr. Irving Bailey. Okay, so Dr. Irving Bailey was the guide of BGL Swami for postdoctoral studies at Harvard University. Okay, so this is regarding his education. Okay, so later on with respect to his work, so after completing his PhD and postdoctorate, so he has been appointed as professor of botany in Presidency College. So later he becomes a head of the department. Then after experience, he also becomes principal of Presidency College in Chennai. Okay, so he has worked a lot in Tamil Nadu. So he has also written books with respect to Tamil Nadu. Okay, I'll be telling about the books that he has written at last. Okay, then he has also got many awards for his research in botany. For research in botany, he has got many awards. The most important one that will be given to the important or for important contributions to botany is Dr. Birbal Sahni Award. Okay. So Pele Botany Award. So which has also been given to Panchanan Maheshwari. Even that award has been given to VGL Swami. So there are around 15 to 20 members who has got this award. Okay. So we have don't have much members who have got this received this award. Okay. So we have only few people. So second person was BGL Swami. First was Panchanan Maheshwari. Okay. So later on, after his work, he has been retired. Okay. Even in his retirement, he has worked with respect to research as well as with respect to classes. Okay. He was an guest professor, or he was a visiting professor of Mysore University for taking some special lectures, special classes. Okay. So after his retirement also, he has worked in Mysore University. Okay. So throughout his career, he was actively involved in research work, especially in the field of embryology of angiosperms or flowering plants. Okay. So these are some of his career or work related things. So later on, we'll focus majorly with respect to the contributions or the works that has been done by BGL Swami. So we'll be focusing on the works that has been done by BGL Swami. Okay. So he has done lot of works in embryology. Along with embryology, he was also working in anatomy. As I told you, when we have discussed about the contributions of Panchanan Maheshwari, that in order to understand one field, especially this embryology, we should be aware of some other branches of botany also, like plant anatomy, we need plant physiology, biochemistry aspects. Okay. So like that, we need many support from other branches of botany also in order to study one particular subject. Okay. So for that reason, so he was able to, or he was interested and worked in embryology as well as even in anatomy. Okay. So that was BGL Swami has worked a lot in embryology, that was influenced by Panchanan Maheshwari. Not only that, he has also contributed major works in the field of anatomy also. Okay. So out of his lot of works, some of the important or major works are under some of the specialized subjects or topics. Okay. So especially, so he was the first person who discovered vessel-less angiosperms. Okay. So we tell that all these angiosperms have vascular system. We tell that all the angiosperms are going to have vascular system. Okay. But there are some families like Winteraceae. Okay. There are some families like Winteraceae and other families which are not going to have vessels. Okay. So we know this xylem vessels. Okay. Now we have trachea elements. So that will be absent in some of the families of angiosperms. So that was discovered by BGL Swami. Okay. So next, he has also worked on the embryology or embryogeny of monocots, monocotyledons. In some of the monocotyledons, he was able to find out the stages for the development of embryo. Okay. Starting from the anther development, starting from the ovule development. Okay. Then with respect to various stages like microsporogenesis, microgametogenesis, megagametogenesis and megasporogenesis. So he has studied all these aspects in detail with respect to monocotyledon members. Majority of the monocotyledon members had these stages, and he has studied all these things. Okay. So apart from this, he has also worked on helobial endosperm. Okay. So you are aware of endosperm. That means it is the nutritive tissue which is going to provide the nutrition or supply their nutrients to the developing embryo. Okay. So that was with respect to the endosperm. Okay. So we have a special type of endosperm called as helobial. So we have different types of endosperm, like we have cellular endosperm, free nuclear endosperm. And the third one is a hybrid of this cellular and free nuclear endosperm, which we call it as helobial endosperm. It is a mixture of cellular and free nuclear endosperm. So that is what we call it as helobial endosperm. So he has also discovered and worked with respect to helobial endosperm, especially in the members, of the order called as helobials of monocotyledons. Okay, so we have an order helobials in monocotyledons. Okay, so that monocotyledons especially are going to have helobial endosperm, which is the mixture of cellular and free nuclear endosperm. So which we will be discussing in detail in the last units. Okay, so about endosperm. Okay, so not only that, I told you he has worked on anatomical aspects, where he has worked with respect to root stem transition. Okay, which means, so the development of root from shoot as well as the development of shoot from root has been discovered or discussed, or he has given detailed description of those concept. Okay, you can get that example from stem cutting. Okay, so if you take some of these stem cuttings like hibiscus or rose, so if you just put it in soil, a stem cutting, we are going to get the roots from that. So that is what the stem root transition. Okay, so in the same way, some of the roots will be giving rise to shoots. Okay, so that is what root stem transition is. So that he has discovered. Okay, then he was also worked, or he has given details or compared the differences, or he was able to compare the original embryos with that of embryoids. As you all know, embryos, which is going to be the multicellular mass of cells developed from zygote through divisions. Okay, my embryo is a multicellular mass of cell which has been developed from zygote through mitotic divisions, and this embryo is going to develop into a new plantlet. Okay, so that was happened in natural means. Okay, that has happened in natural means. Embryos we are going to obtain by natural way, whereas these embryoids will be developed inside the laboratory. Embryoids are nothing but the embryos which has been developed inside the laboratory is what we call it as embryoids. Okay, then apart from this, he was also established the concept of quiescent center in all meristematic zones. That means, so we have shoot apical meristem and root apical meristem, okay, which are going to be present in the stem apex as well as in the root tip, okay, which is going to help for the continued growth of this two shoot and root. This root apical meristem and shoot apical meristem, okay. And one more thing, you would have studied about this organization of meristems. For example, we have zone of division, okay, zone of meristematic activity, zone of elongation, zone of differentiation. So these are the different zones that we are going to come across in case of root apical meristem as well as in case of shoot apical meristem. Okay, so that, in that, we are also going to notice the quiescent centers above this meristematic zone, or in between the meristematic zone and the zone of elongation, we are going to come across the quiescent center. Okay, so this quiescent center will be a reservoir. Quiescent center will be a reservoir of meristematic cells. Okay, whenever there is a damage to the root cap and root apical meristem, this quiescent centers try to give many meristematic cells so that it can recover those damage happened. Okay, that is the advantage of this quiescent center, which has been discovered by BGL Swami. He has established the concept of quiescent centers, how this quiescent center will be playing a role in recovering the damage happened with respect to root apical meristem and root tip. Okay, so apart from this, he was also able to classify the embryo sacs of different types. Okay, so embryo sac, as you all know, is the female gametophyte, 7-celled, 8-nucleated embryo sac, as you all know generally. Okay, but we have many types of embryo sac under this. For example, we will be discussing in detail about these types of embryo sac. Okay. For example, we have monosporic type of embryo sac development, bisporic type, tetrasporic type. So we have three types. One is monosporic, bisporic, and tetrasporic. Okay. So in that we have again subtypes depending upon the divisions. We are going to come across many types, subtypes, etc. Okay. So that we will be discussing in detail in the upcoming classes. So he was able to tell about the types as I am telling now. Okay. He was able to get or form a new classification of embryo sac. Embryo sac yav yav tara idena types na helikondo classification na madidare. So not only that, he was also studied about wood anatomy. Okay, so wood alli yav yava tissue irutte, especially we'll be having the xylem. So in that, which are the elements that are present in that wood, so he was able to do that studies also. Okay, apart from this, he was also given a clear cut relationship between the vascular cambium and procambium. Okay, so vascular cambium means the cambium or the meristematic tissue which is going to be present in the vascular tissue. Okay, we will be telling this cambium, that is intravascular cambium and interfascicular cambium, which is going to help for the secondary growth. Okay, so that was clearly established, or he was able to tell the difference with respect to this vascular cambium and the procambium. Procambium means, so this is going to be present in the young conditions, okay, of this stem. So during young conditions, we are going to come across different types of meristematic tissues. Okay. So if you want to understand these aspects, you are supposed to be aware of second semester syllabus or second semester materials information. Okay. Because these types of cambium, so we'll be having lateral meristematic cambium. Okay. We have different types of floral cambium, leaf primordium, bud cambium. So all these things will be coming there. Okay. So this procambium is primitive cambium, which will be present in the germinating seed, which is going to give rise to different aspects. So he was able to find out the relationship between this vascular cambium and the procambium. Okay. So these are his major works. Okay. So first one was vessel-less angiosperms, monocot embryogeny, then we have elobial endosperm, root stem transition, comparison of embryos and embryoids. It was also established the concept of Poisson center. Okay, in all the meristematic zones. So we have meristematic zones in shoot and root, that is shoot apical meristem and root apical meristem. Okay, then it was also established the classification of embryo sac. He studied about wood anatomy, given articles of papers related to this. He was also established the relationship between the vascular cambium and the procambium. So these are some of his major contributions. So apart from this, he has also done other works. Okay. So I'll be dealing with those things also. Okay. Give me a minute. He has worked on various plants. Okay. So he has worked on various plants. Out of that, there are some plants which are of curiosity. Okay, so he has identified several interesting plants. He was able to identify several interesting plants. Okay, out of that, the special one or one of the important plant was Ascarina. So Ascarina is a genus. Okay, so which was an important plant or an interesting plant with its developmental stages or the growing pattern. These plants which are of curious will be having some of the interesting features. Okay, so here he was able to identify this Ascarina species, and this plant was growing in Pacific Islands. He was able to identify the plant Ascarina, which was growing in Pacific Islands. Okay, then he also given a name in respect or in honor of Panchanan Maheshwari. So after his identification of this plant, he gave the name for this plant as Ascarina Maheshwarii. Okay, he has renamed or identified and renamed this plant as as Karina Maheshwari I. Okay. So it is in respect or in honor of Panchanani Maheshwari, Panchanan Maheshwari. Okay. So that is the first major contribution with respect to plant identification. Apart from that, he was also able to give correct identification. For example, there are some plants which has been wrongly identified even now. Okay. Some people are going to tell different identification or different name for the same plant, and some other people will tell other name for the same plant. Okay. So there are confusions even now. There are confusions even now for some of the plant. So in that way, in with respect to that kind of doubts, he was able to give a clear cut identification to a plant which was wrongly identified earlier. Previously, a plant was wrongly identified or given a wrong name. Okay, so that was clarified by BGL Swami. Okay, and that plant was Sarcandra. Okay, the genus was Sarcandra, and he has named after correcting this identification as Sarcandra Irving Baileyi. Okay, so he was able to identify or give a new name for the plant which was identified wrong earlier. Okay, he has given the name of his guide. Okay, who was postdoctoral guide, Dr. Irving Bailey. Okay, so he has given in honor or in respect of postdoctoral guide to this plant as Sarcandra Irving Baileyi. Sarcandra Irving Baileyi is the plant which was wrongly identified earlier, but he has corrected that identification and given the name of his postdoctoral guide. Okay, so that is with respect to the other second plant. First one was Ascarina Maheshwari. Second plant, that was in honor of Dr. Panchanan Maheshwari, he has identified for the first time. Okay, he has given the name of his motivator Panchanan Maheshwari. Then we have the second one where it was wrongly identified. He has correctly identified and given the name, okay, as Sarcandra Irving Baileyi. Okay, so that is what the second thing is. And as I told you, he was the first person to identify the helobial type of endosperm. So that is the mixture of cellular endosperm and free nuclear endosperm. Okay, so cellular endosperm example is our coconut. What we have this inner coconut material, okay, that is what we are going to have as cellular endosperm. And the liquid endosperm, what we have, tender coconut or the liquid endosperm, is that. Okay, so that will be free nuclear. That will be free nuclear endosperm. So we have both kind of endosperm in case of coconut. That tender, now elnir kudichival venappa, adu free nuclear endosperm. Kubri irthakkantad enide adu cellular endosperm. Artha aagta idiyenappa? But in kelo case alli enagutte antandre eradu mix agirutte. Onde cell anne mele bhagadalli cellular endosperm irutte, kelagade bhagadalli free nuclear endosperm irutte. Onde cell na olagade, artha aagta ide, endosperm tissues alli within a single cell will be finding across the cellular endosperm as well as free nuclear endosperm within the single endosperm tissue. Okay, so that is what is identified by BGL Swami. Okay, especially in the order helobials of monocotyledons. Monocotyledons alli classification madadaga helobials anna ond order sigutte. So alli ivaru mix agirthakkanta endosperm na find out martare for the first time. Okay, so this helobial endosperm is also an identification characteristic feature, andra unique character of this order helobials. Helobials anna order idiyalvanappa, adara important guna adu, you know, helobial endosperm na ittirthakkantadu, artha aita? So that is what the another contribution. And apart from this, we have another theory proposed by him called as con duplicate theory. Okay, so he was able to propose a theory called as con duplicate theory, which is majorly related to the phylogeny of stamens and pistil of a flower. Antandra, ivaru ondu concept na athava theory na propose martare, which is related to the development of anther or stamens. Okay, and pistil. Andra, ಸ್ಟೇಮೆನ್ಸ್ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಮೇಲ್ ರಿಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ಸ್, ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಲ್ವೇನಪ್ಪ ಫಿಲಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಂಥರ್ ಇರುತ್ತಲ್ವ ಅದು ಸ್ಟೇಮೆನ್. ಓಕೆ, ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಕಾರ್ಪೆಲ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಪಿಸ್ಟಿಲ್, ಫ್ಲವರ್ ನ ಮಧ್ಯದಲ್ಲಿ ಇರುತ್ತಲ್ವ ಸ್ಟೈಲ್ ಸ್ಟಿಗ್ಮಾ ಓವರಿ, ಸೊ ಅದು ಕಾರ್ಪೆಲ್. ಅರ್ಥ ಆಯ್ತಾ? ಸೊ ಇದರ ಎರಡು ಬೆಳವಣಿಗೆ ಹೇಗಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಎಲ್ಲಿಂದ ಶುರು ಆಗುತ್ತೆ, ಹೌ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಡೆವಲಪ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಮೆನ್ಷನ್ಡ್ ಆರ್ ಪ್ರಪೋಸ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ಹಿಮ್ ಕಾನ್ ಡೂಪ್ಲಿಕೇಟ್ ಥಿಯರಿ. ಚಿಕ್ಕದಾಗಿದ್ದಾಗಿಂದ ಬಡ್ಡಲ್ಲಿ ಬಡ್ಡಿಗಿಂತ ಮುಂಚೆಯಿಂದ ಹೇಗೆ ಎಲ್ಲ ಬೆಳವಣಿಗೆ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಅನ್ನೋದನ್ನ ಇವ್ರು ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ. ಫೈಲೋಜೆನಿ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಡೆವಲಪ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಪ್ಯಾಟರ್ನ್. ಓಕೆ, ಫೈಲೋಜೆನಿ ಇಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ದಿ ಡೆವಲಪ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಪ್ಯಾಟರ್ನ್. ಹೇಗೆ ಆಯ್ತು ಅದು ಜೆನೆಟಿಕ್ಸ್, ಜೆನೀಸ್ ಜೆನೆಟಿಕ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಫೈಲೋಜೆನಿ ಇಸ್ ಹೌ ಇಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಬಿನ್ ಡೆವಲಪ್ಡ್. ಓಕೆ, ಫ್ರಮ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಟಿಶ್ಯೂ ಲೆವೆಲ್, ಸೆಲ್ಲಾರ್ ಲೆವೆಲ್, ಟಿಶ್ಯೂ ಲೆವೆಲ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ವಿ ಕಾಲ್ ದಟ್ ಆಸ್ ಫೈಲೋಜೆನಿ. ಸೊ ಸೇಮೆನ್ ಹೇಗ್ ಬಂತು, ಕಾರ್ಪೆಲ್ ಹೇಗ್ ಬಂತು ಅನ್ನೋದನ್ನ ಹಿ ವಾಸ್ ಏಬಲ್ ಟು ಗಿವ್ ಎ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ ಕಟ್ ಡೆಫಿನೇಷನ್ ವಿತ್ ದಿ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಎ ಥಿಯರಿ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಕಾನ್ ಡೂಪ್ಲಿಕೇಟ್ ಥಿಯರಿ. ಓಕೆ, ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಒನ್ ಮೋರ್ ಕಾಂಟ್ರಿಬ್ಯೂಷನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಬಿ ಜಿ ಎಲ್ ಸ್ವಾಮಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಅಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದಿಸ್, ಸೊ ಹಿ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಸೆವರಲ್ ವರ್ಕ್ಸ್ ವಿತ್ ರೆಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟ್ ಟು ಎಂಬ್ರಿಯೋಲಜಿ ಆಫ್ ಜಿಮ್ನೋಸ್ಪರ್ಮ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಜಿಮ್ನೋಸ್ಪರ್ಮ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ನಿಮ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಶುರು ಆಗಿದೆ. ಸೊ ಅದರ ಬಗ್ಗೆನೂ ಕೂಡ ಇವರು ಎಂಬ್ರಿಯೋಲಜಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಎಂಬ್ರಿಯೋ ಬೆಳವಣಿಗೆ ಹೇಗಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಮುಂಚೆ ಇರ್ತಕ್ಕಂತ ಸ್ಟೆಪ್ಸ್ ಏನಿದೆ, ಪೋಲನ್ ಗ್ರೈನ್ಸ್ ಹೇಗೆ ಡೆವಲಪ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ, ಎಗ್ ಓವ್ಯೂಲ್ ಹೇಗೆ ಡೆವಲಪ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಅನ್ನೋದು ಕೂಡ ಎಂಬ್ರಿಯೋಲಜಿ ಆಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲೇ ಬರುತ್ತೆ. ಓಕೆ, ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಪೈನಸ್, ಸೈಕಾಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಇವುಗಳ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಎಂಬ್ರಿಯೋಲಜಿಕಲ್ ಸ್ಟಡೀಸ್ ಅನ್ನು ಕೂಡ ಇವರು ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಸೊ ಯಸ್ ಡನ್ ಇವನ್ ದಿ ವರ್ಕ್ಸ್ ಆನ್ ಎಂಬ್ರಿಯೋಲಜಿ ಆಫ್ ಜಿಮ್ನೋಸ್ಪರ್ಮ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ನಾಟ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ದಟ್, ಇವನ್ ಹಿ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ವರ್ಕ್ ಆನ್ ದಿ ಎಂಬ್ರಿಯೋಲಜಿ ಆಫ್ ಆರ್ಕಿಡ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ. ಆರ್ಕಿಡ್ಸ್ ನ ಎಂಬ್ರಿಯೋಲಜಿ ಮೇಲೆ ಕೂಡ ವರ್ಕ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಆರ್ಕಿಡ್ಸ್ ಕಮ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡರ್ ಮೋನೋಕಾಟಿಲಿಡನ್ಸ್, ಮೋನೋಕಾಟಿಲಿಡನೆ. ಅಂಡ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ವೆರಿ ಮೈನ್ಯೂಟ್ ಎಂಬ್ರಿಯೋಸ್ ಆರ್ ವೆರಿ ಮೈನ್ಯೂಟ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಕೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಆರ್ಕಿಡ್ಸ್. ಆರ್ಕಿಡ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ತುಂಬಾ ಮೈಕ್ರೋಸ್ಕೋಪಿಕ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ಸ್ ಇರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥದ್ದು, ಆದ್ರೂ ಕೂಡ ಹಿ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ವರ್ಕ್ಡ್ ಆನ್ ದಟ್. ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಡಿಫಿಕಲ್ಟ್ ಟು ವರ್ಕ್ ಆನ್ ದಿ ಎಂಬ್ರಿಯೋಲಜಿ ಆಫ್ ಆರ್ಕಿಡ್ಸ್. ನಾಟ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಎಂಬ್ರಿಯೋಲಜಿ ಆಫ್ ಆರ್ಕಿಡ್ಸ್, ಈವನ್ ಎನಿ ಎಂಬ್ರಿಯೋಲಜಿಕಲ್ ಆಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಟೇಕ್, ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಡಿಫಿಕಲ್ಟ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ವಿ ನೀಡ್ ಲಾಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೈಕ್ರೋಸ್ಕೋಪಿಕ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್, ಸ್ಟೈನಿಂಗ್ ಟೆಕ್ನಿಕ್ಸ್, ಓಕೆ, ಅಡ್ವಾನ್ಸ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್, ಅಂಡ್ ವಿ ನೀಡ್ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ ಸೆಕ್ಷನಿಂಗ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಹಿಯರ್ ದಿ ಸೆಕ್ಷನಿಂಗ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್. ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಟೇಕ್ ದಿ ಸೆಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಕಾರ್ಪೆಲ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಫ್ಲವರ್ ಸೆಕ್ಷನಿಂಗ್ ಇಸ್ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್, ದಟ್ ಟು ಎಲ್ ಎಸ್ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ಸ್, ಓಕೆ, ಫಾರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಸ್ಟಡೀಸ್. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಡಿಫಿಕಲ್ಟ್ ಟು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಆಲ್ ದೋಸ್ ಸೆಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್, ಬಟ್ ಬೈ ಫಾಲೋಯಿಂಗ್ ದಿಸ್ ವ್ಯಾಕ್ಸ್ ಟೆಕ್ನಿಕ್, ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಡೆಫಿನೆಟ್ಲಿ ಟೇಕ್ ಸೆಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಬೈ ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್ ಮೈಕ್ರೋಟಮಿ. ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಡನ್ ಆಲ್ ದೋಸ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಡನ್ ದಿ ಸ್ಟಡೀಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ದಿ ವರ್ಕ್ ವಾಸ್ ರಿಲೇಟೆಡ್ ಟು ಜಿಮ್ನೋಸ್ಪರ್ಮ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಆರ್ಕಿಡ್ಸ್. ಅಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದಿಸ್, ಹಿ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಗೈಡೆಡ್ 13 PhD ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, 13 PhD ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ವಾಸ್ ಅಂಡರ್ ಈಸ್ ಮೆಂಟರ್ಶಿಪ್. ಸೊ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟೇಕನ್ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಆಫ್ ಫಿಲಾಸಫಿ ಅಂಡರ್ ದಿ ಗೈಡೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಬಿ ಜಿ ಎಲ್ ಸ್ವಾಮಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾಂಡಿಡೇಟ್ಸ್ ವೇರ್ ಸೆಲೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಬೈ ಹಿಮ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಹಿ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಸೆಲೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ದಿ ಕ್ಯಾಂಡಿಡೇಟ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಮೇಡ್ ದೆಮ್ ಟು ಸ್ಟಡಿ ಮೋರ್ ರಿಲೇಟೆಡ್ ಟು ಎಂಬ್ರಿಯೋಲಜಿ ಅಂಡ್ ಇವನ್ ದಿ ಬಾಟ್ನಿ. ಓಕೆ, ದೆನ್ ಹಿ ಹಾನರ್ಡ್ ಅಂಡರ್ ಸಮ್ ಯೂನಿವರ್ಸಿಟಿ ಫಾರ್ ದೀಸ್ ಪಿ ಎಚ್ ಡಿ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ದಿ ಅದರ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಇಸ್. ಸೊ ಅಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದಿಸ್, ಹಿ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಪಬ್ಲಿಷ್ಡ್ ಮೋರ್ ದನ್ 300 ರಿಸರ್ಚ್ ಪೇಪರ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಹಿ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಪಬ್ಲಿಷ್ಡ್ ಮೋರ್ ದನ್ 300 ರಿಸರ್ಚ್ ಪೇಪರ್ಸ್, ದಟ್ ಇನ್ ಇಂಟರ್ನ್ಯಾಷನಲ್ ಅಂಡ್ ನ್ಯಾಷನಲ್ ಜರ್ನಲ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಹಿ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಪಬ್ಲಿಷ್ಡ್ ಹಿಸ್ ರಿಸರ್ಚ್ ವರ್ಕ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಇಂಟರ್ನ್ಯಾಷನಲ್ ಅಂಡ್ ನ್ಯಾಷನಲ್ ಜರ್ನಲ್ಸ್. ಎಸ್ಪೆಷಲಿ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ದಿ ಜರ್ನಲ್ ಮೇಡ್ ಬೈ ಪಂಚನಾರ್ ಮಹೇಶ್ವರಿ. ಓಕೆ, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಫೈಟೋಮಾರ್ಫಾಲಜಿ. ಸೊ ಈವನ್ ಹಿ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಪಬ್ಲಿಷ್ಡ್ ಮೆನಿ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಪೇಪರ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಫೈಟೋಮಾರ್ಫಾಲಜಿ. ಅಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದಿಸ್, ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಸಮ್ ಮೋರ್ ಇಂಟರ್ನ್ಯಾಷನಲ್ ಜರ್ನಲ್ಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಲಾ ಸೆಲ್ಯುಲೆ. ಓಕೆ, ಅಂಡ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಸೈನ್ಸ್, ಈವನ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅವೈಲೇಬಲ್ ಇನ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ. ಸೊ ಈವನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಸೈನ್ಸ್ ಎಸ್ಪೆಷಲಿ ಹಿ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಪಬ್ಲಿಷ್ಡ್ ಮೆನಿ ಪೇಪರ್ಸ್ ಇವನ್ ಇನ್ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಸೈನ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಸಮ್ ಆಫ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಪಬ್ಲಿಕೇಶನ್ಸ್. ಅಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದಿಸ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸೋ ಮೆನಿ ಅದರ್ ಪಬ್ಲಿಕೇಶನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಜರ್ನಲ್ಸ್ ಹಿ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಪಬ್ಲಿಷ್ಡ್. ಸೊ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಸಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಇಂಟರ್ನ್ಯಾಷನಲ್ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಜರ್ನಲ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ದೆನ್ ಆಸ್ ಐ ಟೋಲ್ಡ್ ಯು ದಟ್ ಹಿ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ರಿಸೀವ್ಡ್ ದಿ ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಪ್ರೆಸ್ಟೀಜಿಯಸ್ ಅವಾರ್ಡ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಬೀರ್ಬಾಲ್ ಸಹಾನಿ ಗೋಲ್ಡ್ ಮೆಡಲ್. ಓಕೆ, ಫ್ರಮ್ ಇಂಡಿಯನ್ ಬೊಟಾನಿಕಲ್ ಸೊಸೈಟಿ ಇನ್ 1975. ಫ್ರಮ್ ಇಂಡಿಯನ್ ಬೊಟಾನಿಕಲ್ ಸೊಸೈಟಿ ಹಿ ರಿಸೀವ್ಡ್ ಬೀರ್ಬಲ್ ಸಹಾನಿ ಅವಾರ್ಡ್. ಓಕೆ, ಫಾರ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಕಾಂಟ್ರಿಬ್ಯೂಷನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಫಾರ್ ಹಿಸ್ ವರ್ಕ್ಸ್. Okay. Then, apart from this, so after or because of his contributions, or works to the field of botany, some of his students or some persons have named some of the plants in honor of B.G.L. Swami. In honor of B.G.L. Swami, few plants have been named, not by him, but by others. Maybe students have named these plants. Okay, like we have Bulbostylis Swamii. Okay, so which was named by Govind. Okay, which was named by Govind. One of the plants which was newly identified has been named as Bulbostylis Swamii. Okay, which was named by Govind person. Okay, then there is a gymnosperm, as we all know, Cycas. Okay, so even there is a species called as Cycas Swamii. Okay, which was named in respect or honor of B.G.L. Swami, in remembrance of B.G.L. Swami, they have named these two plants. Okay, so that is about some of his other works or contributions, as well as his honors and medals. Okay, then B.G.L. Swami as a botanist has been recognized internationally because of his research works under embryology and plant anatomy. So he is internationally famous for his works in the research of embryology and plant anatomy. Okay, so apart from this, as I told you that, so he is our Karnataka person. Okay, so he was famous in Karnataka for his writings. Okay, as you all know that much people will not be interested in research and they don't want all these subject oriented things, whereas when it comes to the articles or writings, okay, novels, writings, poems, okay, so this will be interested for the people definitely. So, and one more thing is, so this research will not be accessible to all, and all cannot understand this research works. Okay, that will be, research works can be understood only by people who are aware of those, or they have, if they have some subject knowledge. Okay, so apart from this, so when you come for these writings, novels, poems, etc., so which can be understood by even a layman if they know the language. Okay, so he's written many books in Kannada. Okay, so he is famous in Karnataka for his writings. So he is a most popular writer in Kannada. Okay, so even now there are books which has been republished or reprinted. Okay, now, and even it is having some demand. Okay, so that is with respect to his fame. Then apart from this, so his works, details of his works, his achievements, contributions have been documented in various books by different authors. Okay, they have done this work in honor or in respect or as an appreciation for the work of B.G.L. Swami. Some of his works, achievements, contributions have been mentioned in various books by various authors as a respect and appreciation. Okay, apart from this, so he died on 2nd November 1980. Okay, so these are some of his contributions and works to the field of botany. Okay, so these are related to botany. Apart from this, so he was also able to get many awards in literature. Okay, for his works in Kannada. For example, we have Karnataka Sahitya Academy Award for his writing called as America Dalli Nanu. Okay, so America Dalli, when he was in America, so he has faced many things. He has written all his experience of America in this book, America Dalli Nanu. Then he has also received Sahitya Academy Award for a book called as Hasiru Vannu, okay, in 1978. Okay, so this Hasiru Vannu is related more to plants. Okay, so he has written more in with respect to plants in this book. Okay, Adbito, he has also obtained other awards from government of Karnataka, like Rajyotsava Prashasti. Then even Kannada Sahitya Parishat has also awarded him. Okay, apart from this, as you all know, from government of India, that is from Indian Botanical Society, he received Birbal Sahni Gold Medal in 1976 for his works in botany. Okay, so apart from this, we'll go ahead. we'll go ahead. Some of the books written by BGL Swami in Kannada. In Kannada, he's written many books. As you can go through this, you can go through a list. Okay, Asuravanno, we have College Ranga, College Taranga. These two are related to college life. Okay, he has written best in these books, which even if you read these books, you will feel interesting. Okay, so that is the college life books he has written. Then apart from this, so he has written books on his life, wherever and whenever he was in different positions. So when he was in college, he has written those three books. And when he was when he has become professor, Pradhyapakana Peetadalli. Okay, so how was the experience? So that he has mentioned in this book. Okay, and when he was working in Tamil Nadu, so he has written the book called as Tamilu Thalegala Nadve. Tamilu Thalegala Nadve and a book barthidara. So adbitto, when he was in America, as I told you, so he was able to have food of America. So we were not getting Indian food there na. So during that time, so he was telling about the food that was there in his stomach. Okay, so that is namma hotel Dakshina America. Not only during that time, even now we are having foods which are related to this Dakshina America, North America. So we have many potato, tomato, some of these species are from this America, North America in the bandirthakkanta food. Adara bagyanu kuda he has mentioned in this book. Okay, so adbitto, there are many books like Pancha Kalasha Gopura, America dalli nanu, as I told you, Mysuru Diary. So when he was in Mysore, which is little bit incomplete. And then we have Dorgandhi Kaparana, Falashruti, Sakshat Karada Dariyalli, Sasya Purana, Bruhadaranyaka, Beladingalalli Aralida Mule, Jnana Ratha, Aradihe Bala, Balav Kaveri, Meenakshiya Sauganda, Shasanagalalli so Gidamaragalu, Huvininda Kaige. Okay, so this is all major things related to his research also. Okay, he has also shared his experience through these books of his life. Not only that, you can see from these books, so maximum are related to plants. Maximum are related to plants. Plant life ke sambandhapattange irthakkanta books ivellavu kuda nu kannadadalli ide. Okay, so he was the first person who was also able to write botany, sasya shastra anta en karithive adanna major agi kuda nu bardidare. Okay, so woven in the kaige, that means embryology, that is from flower to fruit. Okay, flower to fruit. What are the developmental stages? Hege antaru stamensu development aitu, carpel development aitu, adral enenitu pollination enaitu. So he has mentioned all those things in this book. Okay, so these books are maximum kelu books matra available ide, but some are not available. Okay, so especially this ಹೂವಿನಿಂದ ಕಾಯಿಗೆ ಅನ್ನುವಂಥದ್ದಾಗಿರಲಿ ಅವೆಲ್ಲ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಅವೈಲೇಬಲ್ ಇದೆ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಟ್ರೈ ಟೇಕಿಂಗ್ ಸಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಬುಕ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಯು ಈವನ್ ರೀಡ್, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ಅ ಲಾಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್. ಅಂಡ್ ಒನ್ ಮೋರ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಈಸ್, ಸೊ ಇನ್ ಇಸ್ ಬುಕ್ಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಕಾಲೇಜ್ ತರಂಗ ಹಸಿರುವನ್ನು, ಹಿ ಹಸ್ ಮೆನ್ಷನ್ಡ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್ ಟ್ರಿಪ್ಸ್, ಸ್ಟಡಿ ಟ್ರಿಪ್ಸ್ ಟು ವೇರಿಯಸ್ ಫಾರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಏರಿಯಾಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಹಿ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಮೆನ್ಷನಿಂಗ್ ಈಚ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಎವ್ರಿ ಸ್ಟೆಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಜರ್ನಿ ದೇರ್. ಓಕೆ, ವಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ಡ್, what all the things that has happened in his books. So you can read, it will be little bit interesting. You can take this Asuravanno, College Taranga especially. Okay, and even you can read this Shasanagalalli Gidamaragalu. So these are okay. And even the Namma Hotel Dakshina America, America dalli nanu is also good. And even Tamilu Thalegala Nadve adu kuda chenagide. So if you are interested, you can read these books. Okay, it will create some sort of interest for reading books as well as about the nature. Okay, so you can go through these books. Okay, so these are some more for some of the photographs when he was working on the plant. Okay, then so he has also drawn some of the pictures related to the evolution of tracheary elements. Okay, so xylem vessels anta karithivalvenappa adu hege evolve aitu annodike on chitra vedisidaru, how it has been evolved, evolution of tracheary elements has been mentioned here clearly. Tumba simple agittu initially, and it became little bit complicated with all wall thickenings and development of pits. Wall thickenings ella develop aagi hege final conclude aitu vessels anadra bage illi mention madidare. Okay, so apart from this, as we all know, this chaprad badnekai anta karithivalanappa, so adra bage nu kuda he has mentioned in his Kannada book. Okay, so this is what regarding embryological studies that has done by BGL Swami. So he has also done some paintings, cartoon paintings by BGL Swami. and his research work on Cymbidium bicolor. So Cymbidium bicolor is an orchid. ಆರ್ಕಿಡ್ ಮೇಲೂ ಕೂಡ ಅದರ ಫಿಮೇಲ್ ಗೆಮೆಟಫೈಟ್ ಹೇಗಿರುತ್ತೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಎಂಬ್ರಿಯೋ ಸ್ಯಾಕ್. ಹೌದು, ಎಂಬ್ರಿಯೋ ಸ್ಯಾಕ್ ಇಲ್ಲಿದೆ, ಕಾಣ್ತಾ ಇದೆ, ನೋಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ರೇನಪ್ಪ. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಎಗ್ ಆಪರೇಟಸ್, ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಂಟಿಪೋಡಲ್ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ವಿ ಹಾವ್ ದಿಸ್ ಒನ್ ಆಸ್ ದಿ ಪೋಲಾರ್ ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಫಿಮೇಲ್ ಗೆಮೆಟಫೈಟ್ ಹೇಗೆ ಡೆವಲಪ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಗಿದೆ ನೋಡಿ. ಫ್ರಮ್ ಮೋನೋಸ್ಪೋರಿಕ್ ಫಂಕ್ಷನಲ್ ಮೆಗಾಸ್ಪೋರ್ ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಟು ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಎ ಡಯಾಡ್. ಫ್ರಮ್ ಡಯಾಡ್ ಸೊ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಒನ್ ಫಂಕ್ಷನಲ್ ಡಯಾಡ್ ಗಿವನ್ ರೈಸ್ ಟು ಫೋರ್ ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯೇಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ಔಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದಟ್ so we are going to get this 7-celled 8-nucleated embryo sac. Okay, this is what he has done. Illi 8 nucleate condition ide, illi 4 nucleate condition ide, so 2 nucleate condition ide. There is movement of this nucleus towards their respective poles. So all these things he has mentioned and worked on this. Apart from this, even on Parthenium, so you tell Parthenium as a waste plant. Okay, but see, even considering or even by knowing the fact of Parthenium, he has worked on that. Even he has studied about the female gametophyte and embryogeny. Idralu kuda embryological studies madidara. Andre this is the flower what we have. This is the flower in case of Parthenium. Okay, even in this small flower he has worked with respect to embryological aspect. Okay, so this is one more contributions. Apart from this, as I told you, so these are books of his edition. Okay, so College Oranga. Then with respect to Diary of a Botanist, English book written by B.G.L. Swami. So this is, these are some more books, and we have Asuravana from by B.G.L. Swami. Then we have Namma Otteli, Dakshin America by B.G.L. Swami. Okay, even in YouTube. So even in YouTube, you can put B.G.L. Swami documentary. You can definitely get the documentary of B.G.L. Swami. Okay, Swami Ananta Madidara documentary, which includes complete is the life story, biography adral poorthi ide. So you can understand even some of the aspects of his work and his life story through this video. Okay, so you can get it from YouTube. Okay, so this is all related to the works as well as the honors, respects and his remembrances things. Okay, so finally I conclude that so B.G.L. Swami was not only a botanist, so he was also a good writer. Okay, not only a good writer, he was also able to tell about many aspects of life. Okay, so that is, he was a multifaceted polyglot. So he was also familiar with various languages. Okay, so he was also familiar with Indian language, even foreign languages. He was well known for Kannada, has even written books. Even he has written books in Tamil. Okay, Tamil alo kuda nu kelu books bardidara. So he is famous even in Tamil, and he also know Telugu, and to some extent he was aware of Malayalam language. Apart from this, with respect to foreign languages, so okay, so he was well versed with English. Okay, even with French, he has studied French. He was good at German, and he was also speaking Spanish to some extent. Okay, so this was his language proficiency. And with respect to his, yeah, that is what we are mentioning as multifaceted polyglot. He was also a good painter, artist, good artist, cartoonist. He was able to draw many cartoonists that we have seen from the picture. Okay, so he is also, from the picture we can see here, so he is holding violin in his hand. Okay, he was also an instrument player. So he was interested in music also. He was a good violin player. Okay, not only that, he has also worked as writer for newspaper. So he worked as music critic for the Hindu newspaper. He translated Kirtanas of Purandaradasa into Tamil. See, this is what the poet characteristic is. So he has also translated for Tamil people to understand the Kirtanas written by Purandaradasa. Okay, and he has also rendered in musical concerts. Okay, so he also had good knowledge of inscriptions. Inscription antandre ale shashanagalu anta en karithivalva nappa kall mele ellaadru ketne maadirthakkantadagirli santada inscriptions anta karithivu adrame adru bagge kuda avarge thumba knowledge ittu. Okay, so that is what he has also written in book. Okay, hale shashanagalalli gida maragalu anna book alli baddidare hege hale kaaladalli gidagalna balisidru gidagalu hege they have played the role in the life of people annadru bagge helidru. Okay, so then after his retirement, he came back to Bangalore, and he was associated himself with the activities of Kannada Vijnana Parishad. Okay. Then he was also became the president of Karnataka Vijnana Parishad. Then he has tried to create more scientific awareness among people, among students, people especially. Okay. And sought to it that more and more people write scientific articles in Kannada. See. So his interest was to bring out many articles in Kannada apart from English research. English research aagtane anta, but aa time alane aa kaaladalane avara interest enittu. So he wanted people to write research articles in Kannada. Okay. So that was his works and his talent. Okay. Related to various aspects. So this literature or the information what I have gathered is not available in any of the books. So BGL Swami bagge books alli namage sigodilla taitanappa. So this has to be obtained from internet resource only. So I have many books of embryology where I don't have information about BGL Swami, but allalalle matra one add point matra sigbodu andre regarding his works. Okay. So apart from this, maximum information has been obtained from the websites. Okay, I have posted or pasted the links of all those websites. Okay, so if you want, you can write down or you can go through this, then you can get the information. So this is all related to the contributions of BGL Swami to embryology.